Felt can be used to create almost anything, including panels, beads, fringes, and cords. In this brief video tutorial, I will teach you how to quickly and efficiently make felt cords from wool. Cords and our basic elements of felt making. For this tutorial, I will use 18-19 micron merino wool tops. While any wool thickness or micron count can be used depending on the desired product, I will use fine and delicate merino wool for clarity in the video. You will need a bowl of room temperature water, a piece of soap, bubble wrap, or any other textured waterproof surface that is convenient for felting. A spray bottle can also be useful. Additionally, you will need a rubberized net for felting, or a rubber or bamboo mat for sushi, and a cotton towel. First, take a piece of wool top about 10% longer than the desired finished cord. With this method, the shrinkage will be minimal. Place the wool top on a textured surface and roll it dry with your hands initially, just to lightly bind the fibers. Next, lightly spray the table surface with water and continue rolling the wool gently with your hands. To form the cord, do not press too hard as this will compress the wool into a ribbon instead of a cord. Aim for light, gentle movements with soapy hands to felt the wool roll into a cord. Continue to add soap to your hands to maintain a light lather and gradually increase pressure as the cord firms up. The first stage of felting is now complete. The cord is still soft and delicate, so avoid pressing it into a ribbon. Continue rolling the cord on the table, pushing it forward and back until it becomes more resilient. Once it reaches this stage, move on to the second stage of felting using a textured mat. Place the cord in the mat and roll it as if you were making sushi rolls. This stage requires light but firm movements, using the strength of your hands rather than your entire body weight. Preparing several cords in advance for the second stage can be convenient. If you need multiple cords, prepare several blanks and complete the first stage of felting with them. Then you can place as many pre-felt cord blanks as you need into the mat. It could be 2, 3, 5, or even 10, and roll them all together in the mat. Woolen cords are frequently used for decorating felted items. They can be used to create unique relief patterns or simply serve as laces. For this purpose, the cord blank should be made thinner, and such cords can become excellent laces for shoes or clothing. If we need laces for shoes or clothing, they should be felted to a soft and elastic state. However, if we want to use woolen cords for jewelry, such as necklaces or braided accessories, we need them to be more resilient, like handles for bags. In that case, the cords should be very firm and dense, requiring additional felting. You will notice that with this technique, the length shrinkage of the cord is minimal. At the beginning, the cord slightly extended beyond the edges of the mat. Now, it fits within the mat's boundaries, with approximately 10% shrinkage in length. The main shrinkage occurs in the density and thickness of the cord as the wool fibers interlock and form felt. To achieve the necessary density and resilience, additional felting steps are needed. Felt it as you would any other woolen item. Roll it like a snowball or knead it like a piece of dough. You can tap it on the table, performing all the usual felting procedures to make it truly dense. In the second stage of felting, you can alternate between different techniques: dough, snowball, roll, and then additionally roll it on a textured surface to achieve the desired density and resilience of the wool. If you are felting a cord to make bag handles, it needs to be felted until no transverse wrinkles appear when bending the wet cord. It should bend but remain smooth. This is one of the crucial indicators of a ready woolen cord and guarantees that it will not stretch or tear in the future. Unlike smooth felt fabric, you won't see the felt grain, small bumps on the surface, so you should focus on the resilience and absence of transverse wrinkles. The finished cord should be strong, resilient, and smooth without wrinkles. This is the main quality criterion. The time required to make such a cord is quite short but not instantaneous. I spent 5 to 7 minutes on this cord, even while explaining the process to you. Longer or thicker cords will require additional time. Reaches the desired firmness and smoothness, rinse it thoroughly in room temperature water. For additional shrinkage, you can alternate between hot and cold water. Ensure all soap is washed out completely. Finally, unleash your creativity with your felt cords. In the next video tutorial, I will show you how to make multi-layered felt cords, another simple and effective felting technique that you will find useful. Subscribe to my channel, like this video if you enjoyed it, ask your questions in the comments, and share the link with friends. I'll see you soon in the next tutorial.